Students, we have done in a triangle what are exterior points, what are interior points, what are interior angles of the triangle. See, if we have one triangle and if I take one point P in the interior of this triangle, then this point is interior point of the triangle, and if I take the angles inside this triangle, this is interior angles of this triangle. Now if I take any point Q, R, S, any points, these are exterior points of the triangle. Now we will move to exterior angles of a triangle. Exterior angles in this triangle, if I take it as a linear pair, so they will make angle of 180 degree, then this will be the interior angle and the outside angle will be the exterior angle of the triangle. So if we name the triangle as A, B, C, and I take this BX ray just opposite to BC, then ABC, ABX, these are adjacent angles and they form linear pair also because their sum is equal to 180 degree. So in a linear pair, the angle inside the triangle is interior angle and angle outside the triangle is exterior angle. And these two angles which are just opposite to this angle, the interior angle with this exterior angle, so these are interior opposite angle of this exterior angle. If we want to tell the interior opposite angles, so these are the adjacent angles, not the opposite angles. So for which angles will be opposite to this angle? BAC and BCA, these two angles are interior opposite angles of this exterior angle. Now if we want to take the exterior angle of this C, this point C, so we will take this row like this, this ray. So what will be the exterior angle? A, C and Y, this will be the exterior angle. And what are the interior opposite angle to angle this C? They are angle A and angle B, interior opposite angles. Similarly, we can take at A also, exterior angle at A is this. If I take it as Z, then this will be the exterior angle A. Exterior angle A, opposite interior angles will be angle B and angle C, because this is a adjacent angle to exterior angle. So this interior angle is adjacent, that cannot be opposite, and opposite angles are these two angles. These are opposite to this exterior angle A. Exterior angle B, opposite interior opposite angles are angle A and angle C. For angle C, exterior interior opposite angles are angle A and angle B. So now if we move to our worksheet 3, name all the exterior angles in the given triangle. This is the triangle given to you and you have to find the exterior angles only. So in one is the interior angle, then exterior angle will be 5. So angle 5 will be the exterior angle. In this, exterior angle will be angle 6, and in this, exterior angle will be angle 4. then 5, 6 and 4 are the exterior angles. Now in question number 2, complete the table given below. You have to find exterior angle, interior adjacent angle of the exterior angle and interior opposite angles of this exterior angle. So first of all, what will be the exterior angle? This one will be the exterior angle. Name, angle PRS. So exterior angle will be angle PRS. Interior adjacent angle of this exterior angle will be this PRQ. PRQ. And interior opposite angles are these angles, angle P and angle Q. You can say RPQ, PQR. Or simply you can say angle P and angle Q. In this, exterior angle will be this one. YZV, angle YZV, this will be the exterior angle and interior adjacent angle will be this angle YZX, YZX, and interior opposite angles, will be these two angles, angle Y and angle Z. You can simply write angle Y and angle Z. So I am writing YXZ and XYZ, or I can write simply X or simply Y. Here I can write simply P or angle Q simply. Now in part C, exterior angle will be this CAD. So our exterior angle in this part is angle CAD and its interior adjacent angle will be this one CAB, and interior opposite angles are angle C and angle B, or we can say angle ACB, ABC. ACB or angle C, angle ABC or angle B. Now in question number 3, look at the figure and complete the given statements. This is the figure given to you and you have to read interior opposite angles corresponding to the exterior angle 5R. First of all, it is exterior angle 5 and you have to find interior opposite angles. So interior, first of all you have to find the interior angles. These three are interior angles. This is the adjacent angle to angle 5. So opposite angles are angle 2 and angle 3 and they are interior angles. So interior opposite angles to angle 5 are angle 2 and angle 3. Now interior adjacent angle corresponding to angle 6. Here is exterior angle 6, then interior adjacent angle, is just, so that will be angle 2. Exterior angle at the vertex R. This is vertex R and what will be the exterior angle of this vertex R? That is angle 4. Interior opposite angles corresponding to the exterior angle 6. This is exterior angle 6 and interior opposite angles. So interior angles are 1, 2 and 3, but 2 is adjacent to this angle 6. So opposite angles are angle 1 and angle 3. Interior adjacent angle corresponding to exterior angle at vertex P. Here is vertex P. exterior angle is angle 5, then adjacent angle will angle 1. So this done your worksheet 3 and completes your chapter 12. We do MCQs and blanks of this chapter of BT. So now we will start BT. Which of the following can be angles of a triangle? So to find the angles of the triangle, if three angles are given, you just add them. 40 plus 30 is 70. 70 plus 45 is 115. So this cannot be. If we add these, see here, two obtuse angles are there. If two obtuse angles are there and their sum will be greater than 180 degree, so they cannot be the angles of a triangle because two obtuse angles are there. And in a triangle, not two obtuse angles can be. Now, in this, find the sum of these. 35 and 50 is 85. 85 and 70 is 155. So this cannot also not be the angles of the triangle because their sum is not equal to 180 degree. Now if we add them, this is 30 plus 55 is 85. 85 plus 90 is 180. So this can be the angles of the triangle. So you will solve all the sums, all the options given. Two equal angles of a triangle are of measure 70 degree each. Two angles 70 degree, 70 degree. You have to find the third angle. So two angles, sum of two angles is 70 and 70, that is 140. And to find the third angle, what will we do? We subtract 140 from 180. We get 40 degree, then third angle will 40 degree. The side opposite to the vertex X of triangle XYZ. This is triangle XYZ. Opposite side will be YZ. Opposite side, in opposite side, no vertex X should be there. So YZ will be the opposite side of triangle XYZ to a vertex X. A triangle can have dash exterior angles. See, in this question, see, we have three angles, three interior angles, and also three exterior angles. So we have three exterior angles in one triangle. In total we have six angles, but exterior angle are three and interior angle are also three. Two angles of a triangle are 35 and 85. What type of triangle is this? 35 and 50, sorry, that will be 85. If we subtract this, see, this is acute, the sum is acute, then that will be obtuse. Next angle, we get 95 degree. So 95 degree is obtuse angle, and one angle is obtuse, then we have obtuse angle triangle. So it will be obtuse angle triangle. Now we will do question number 4. The three dash of a triangle are non-collinear. Non-collinear, beta, in non-collinear or collinear, there are points. And in triangle, points are called the vertex. So, three, the plural of vertex is vertices. The three vertices of a triangle are non-collinear. Side opposite to vertex C. Vertex C is there, so side opposite side will be side AB. Vertex opposite to side XZ. Y is not there, then the opposite vertex will be Y. The other two angles of a right triangles are, they are always acute Each angle of equilateral triangle measures, as I told you, they are same angles. Suppose they are x, x and x. If we add them, we get 180 degree and 180 degree divided by 3, we get 60 degree. Then degrees is written, so no need to write the degree. So each angle of equilateral triangle measures 60 degree. It is all done about chapter 12.